This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, the prominent differences that is associated is will be having 8 configurations. Instead of seven, here you will be having 8 configuration files. That is the first major difference. It was very slow. Net was found to be very slow, or machine was found to be very slow. I couldn't make sense. Okay, right. We have 8 configuration files. So with respect to this directional file, we have this yarn-site.xml file. Okay, so then we have incore-site.xml file. In our own context, we will be doing two things. One is the temporary directory and the name node. Here I want to specify the name nodes IP address. I now need to create temporary directory here. I need to create a temporary directory under https://site.xml file. Okay, under https://site.xml, I need to specify the block replica, the number of blocks that it need to be replicated. If you want to overwrite the default value of 3, you need to specify here. You need to create a name node. Temporary directory, and you want to create the temporary directory for data nodes also. Both these two directories need to be created here. https://site.xml. Okay, so in yarn-site.xml, you need to specify this schedulers. Okay, want to specify this yarn associated files in yarn-site.xml. And these configuration files will be presented under the location where you have installed Hadoop, under home, under Hadoop. So we have a folder by name Hadoop, iPhone 2.7, any version, okay, 2.7.0, under etc, under Hadoop, all these configuration files will be presented. That's all, okay. So I will share you a document. Let me open this document. Hadoop installation. Okay, here it is. Hadoop 2.x single node installation. So it is little bit slow, okay, so please, sir. Here we can find all of the steps are same. Here, this is the location under home Hadoop. So here, instead of Hadoop, what you need to replace here, you want to replace it with your username that you are creating. So if you are going to make use of AWS Cloud, here instead of Hadoop, you want to replace it with Ubuntu. Being we are going to make use of Ubuntu, here we need to specify instead of Hadoop, it is Ubuntu. Okay. It is your choice. Okay, the username. If you are having a username Raman means, then it will be under the /Raman. Okay, it is not mandatory that you need to install Hadoop here. You can install Hadoop anywhere, but my document and installation will be under the home path. Okay, so you can decide your choice. So apart from that, what we need to do? Then you can find this master node. Okay, here we have under the property fs.default name as it is fs open source. The second thing, the port number, the master node license here is 9000. It is not 53518 there. In our Hadoop 1.x, the port number is different. Here, the port number, the master license is 9000. Okay, this is the second prominent differences in terms of the port that it is listening. And with respect to this HTTP-site.xml, now you can find this property. Okay, so we have a DFS.replication is already one. Why so? Because since it is a single node. And then you want to specify DFS.nameNode.name.dir, and you want to create a folder. Any folder that you can create, you specify here under home Ubuntu name node. Similarly, so I also change this configuration. Okay, under home, so that it will be easy for you. Ubuntu, it is assumed that you are going to work with AWS. And if it is AWS, the version that it is supported is Ubuntu 18. Therefore, Java minimum JDK 8 and above. Okay. Then you want to set this property. This is optional. So DFS start permission is false. It's optional. Whether you can set or not doesn't matter. Okay. So here it will be applicable while you are dealing with a multi-node cluster. At that time, I will let you know. So these are all the three properties that you need to set. Okay. DFS replication value need to be one. And then here the second property, DFS start name node. You want to create a temporary directory for name node, and you want to create a temporary directory for data node. Okay, so it is not the name node, you can specify any name, but the location need to be specified under the key dfs.nameNode.name.dir. The dfs.datanode.data.dir. Okay, so these are all the two folders which holds some intermediate data during the process that is taking place in name node and data node. And with respect to this mapper-site.xml, here you want to specify the job tracker. Okay, being it is a single node, so you have the name node IP address mapper.jobTracker. Okay, so here the job tracker activity has been taken care of by the MapReduce framework. Okay, so here the MapReduce framework comes a part of YARN. Therefore, you want to include this additional thing mapReduce.framework.names equal to YARN. Normally in 1.x, this is sufficient enough, being you have job tracker. In this, here, the job tracker has been replaced by two things. One is resource manager, and another one is application master. Okay, so here, instead of that, what we need to specify? So the framework which is taking care of this job related execution is YARN framework. Therefore, you need to specify the property. The framework is YARN. And this is the additional information that you need to go for. You hear? You need to specify two things. Under YARN, you need to specify two things. One is the YARN.NodeManager.AuxiliaryService is MapReduce Shuffle. and you need to specify the class file, shuffle handler, okay, yarn dot node manager dot auxiliary services dot shuffle class. These are on these files will provide you the enough information needed to make use of this multi-tenancy and Hadoop two-part-x features. Okay, that thing you need to specify under yarn-site.xml. So here you can also configure the resource manager as scheduler. Okay, so which is running under the following code. This is optional. Okay, this is optional. In case of multi-node, you can make use of it. Where the resource manager is, where the scheduler is. Okay, so these are all the way by which you can make it. So even though in single node also you can configure, it will automatically launches your resource manager and scheduler. Okay, but it is mandatory in Hadoop 2.x. These are all the property file that it is associated with yarn-site.xml. Then after that, under the slaves, you have a slave. You won't have a master file. Also because since there is no secondary name node, you won't have a master file. Under the slaves, you need to specify the IP address or host name of the data node. If you have multiple data nodes, each and every IP address need to be specified one by one. Okay. So under the Hadoop environment data state, as usual, you need to specify the Java scope path. Okay, so these are all the entry that it is associated with the master nodes. If it is a multi-node only, you need to do this slave node. As of now, you no need to do this concept of slave nodes. Okay, so here I have this document reports both a multi-node configuration. Here you just follow these steps up to what I have specified under master. Okay, so you no need to go for this slave node. So here adobe-environment.sk, yarn-site.xml, mapred-site, hdfs-site, core-site.xml. And another thing, you have there is no slaves file. Okay, you can leave it. And then another information that you want to specify is .bash-rc. So under .bash-rc, you need to have the following folder. Okay, you need to have the entire thing. Right. You want to specify the Hadoop home path, /ubuntu. Okay, Hadoop 2, but it is you want to decide this version, which version currently you are downloading. Hadoop configuration directory, hadoop_conf.directory. This is the location where you can find Hadoop configuration directory. And then Hadoop mapred_home, Hadoop common_home. All these point out to the Hadoop home path. Okay, so yarn_home. Where you have installed Hadoop that you need to specify. Similarly, export the Java path, then export the class path. Okay, the class path is nothing but the bin folder of Java and Hadoop home. Along with that, you need to include a sbin here, the starting script and stopping script, to start script and stop script, to start and stop the server. So it's with this sbin. Okay, so therefore you need to specify this sbin. So these are all the configurations that you need to specify. Okay, so after that, what you need to do next step, you have to issue source bash rc. Okay, source bash rc. So this source bash rc is used to reread the configuration files without restarting the server. Then after that, what we need to do, we want to start the services. Okay, so we can start the services. First type as usual. Okay, so let me copy this so that it will be easy for you. Source bash rc. Next step. To keep this document for a single node alone. Okay, for multi node, I will do some modifications. Then after that, source bash rc, you need to start the services. You no need to do this etc host and mapping here. Yeah, these are all optional things. Okay, you guys please understand. You no need to go for etc host and etc host name editing. These are all optional things. Without that itself, it will work. Then you need to create the following thing. before source bash rc, you should have created a directory. So, okay, so after specifying all these things, here you can find home Ubuntu name node and home Ubuntu data node. These two folders have been created, and you need to specify these two folders before going for bash rc. Okay, so under the create that, it is not mandatory that you need to create under the same name node and data node. It is your choice. It is your location. Here I created this under the location. After that, bash rc. Okay. Step 4A. Step 5. Step 6. Okay, so after that, for the first time, you need to format the name node. As usual, you need to format the name node. Okay, so here, this key execution, generating the key, everything that you need to do here. Okay, under home, we have already mentioned it. Copy the key, it needs to be done prior itself, right? Let me check whether it is having or not. Okay, so here install Java, check Java, generate SSH key, then here you need to copy the key, okay, 2A, 2B. Copy the key generated in the master node as a result of executing 2A to batch layer nodes using the below commands. Here, to the using the below commands. Okay. Copy under home Ubuntu dot SSH ID underscore RSA dot bub under the authorize underscore keys. Okay. This is the key generation portion. apt-get install open SSH key gen, and then you can generate a Java, and then check Java, download the Hadoop, extract the Hadoop, edit the configuration files. Okay, these are all the configuration types of editing that you need to make, and then okay, create this folder and make this source bash rc, and finally you do the formatting. Okay, so you want to format the name node for the first time. So navigate to the next step. Navigate to the current warning location. Okay. So, and you want to start the services. So navigate to the folder where you have installed for the first time, cd home ubuntu hadoop 2.10 bin slash hadoop name node hyphen format. And then next step, so go to the sbin folder. Please make a note. So here the services that you need to start, here is in sbin folder. Okay, home ubuntu sbin, here dot slash start hyphen hard dot sh. Okay, so this is the process that it is associated with. Okay, so you can verify using this URL. If you do this, you can verify using this web browser itself. So to stop the services, similarly you need to go for with this same thing. So open a URL and type the in the IP address of the your master machine colon 30070. It will open a web browser. Okay, in the web browser you can able to view all the information. So if it is cloud, then you need to specify the DNS address. Please make a note. Okay, if it is cloud, you need to specify the DNS address. This web browser will be open and you can surf through the web browser. Okay, so this is the way. And then here to stop the services, you want to stop properly, stop the services, and then only you can come out of it. If not, if you directly shut down, it will lead to corruption. Yes, is it clear? Okay, I will remove all other things, else it will be confusing you. So this is the document that you need to follow. Alt-F. Save us. Auto to contact single node. Okay, sit there now. What we need to do? Do you have any clarification? Arun, Pavan, Sanjay, Vijay, am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, first I will share this document so that it will be easy for you. Can anyone try now concurrently? Let me check it. I will give you access control. Can anyone try this now?
Yes, we can try.
I will share you the control of your meeting. My machine was founded very slow.
Yeah, Shri Ram, I have not attended that Friday session. Can you send me the recordings for Friday one?
Friday system, I already told. Friday system, we have, I think so, we have discussed about a single node installation.
Okay.
Yes, that was not properly recorded. It was recorded only for 3 minutes. So I had to send you another class session with the same recording on the day itself, I informed.
Okay. Because I haven't attended the session. Till now, I didn't receive the recordings, which you are, and even another one, I didn't receive that.
So you send me again. So I had you a single node installation we discussed on Friday. It was recorded only 3 minutes only.
Okay.
Therefore, I had already shared it with my capture.
Ram, can you hear me?
Now I will.
Raman?
It was very slow. Why I put it in? Yes?
Can you hear me, Raman?
Yes, please.
Sanjay here.
Yeah, Raman, yeah. Maybe we can try from our side, Raman, maybe installation, if you're on the grease.
So the installation, my machine was found to be very slow. I don't know what is the reason. For each and every click itself, that's the reason why I asked you to try. No, I will.
Yeah,
what I'm saying, Raman, we will try from in our machines, maybe, you know, after
that's,
the session.
That's what he's saying. That's, no, Vijay, that's what he's saying. His system is slow. So he wants us to do
my
it on our end.
Morning onwards. Can I restart?
Can we can do
so
that?
Also, let me restart one time. Or, okay, let us restart. Okay, Sanjay, it's good. Sanjay is ready to install at his side. Let a one time restart. Yes, Sanjay.
You can hear me, Raman?
Yes.
Can you hear me? You can hear me, right?
I am making Sanjay as a presenter. Yeah. Yes, Sanjay. Sanjay, I made you as a presenter. Mail notification to you, yes, message notification to you. You kindly click on and you share your screen now, Sanjay. Before that, I will share you the document. Please let me wait a while. I will share you the document. Please wait a while. And fine, loading this mail itself is taking a lot of time. So can I restart on time? Guys, you also please restart. Let me try. Let me restart only on time. Okay. It will be down now. Please restart. I am going to restart. You also please restart.